Bonjour mesdames et messieurs, in this video I want to talk to you about Luminosity Mask and Lightroom Classic. It's a really cool feature. It really can change your photography where you can just make the sky darker without affecting the rest of the elements of the photo or change the color of an object. You'll see it's a really cool feature, something you must absolutely know. Let's get started. So this is a photo of the Place Vendôme that I took last month in Paris. I'm gonna do a basic retouching, open the shadows, bring down the highlights. I'm gonna do crush the blacks and the whites. And I like the photo, but I wish I could darken the sky a bit more because you know how the eyes goes to the brightest part of the photo. So I'm gonna go here, I'm gonna double click on effect, and I'm gonna lower the exposure and make a gradient. But here's the problem. My sky is darkened, but the building is darkened, and the obelisk of the Place Vendôme is darkened. So what can we do? So now check this out. I can hold down the Option key on the Mac, which is the Alt key on Windows, and I can move this to the right. And basically this is gonna create a mask. So remember, a mask is white reveals, black conceal. So if I click on the range mask with the Option key, you see it's all white, meaning this whole white part, which is like a selection, is going to be affected by this slider. You can also see it here by clicking Show Selected Mask Overlay. You can see this just shows you what this slider will affect. It's not going to affect the bottom part, but only the red part, okay? But check this out. As you hold down the Option key and you move this to the right, you will see that the buildings become darker and darker and darker, okay? And not all the buildings, but some of the buildings become darker and darker, and that creates a mask. And the mask is going to conceal. It's going to stop this slider, that effect, to go on the building. So let me show you. Check this out. Before, everything is being affected. After, the sky is less effective, but check it out. Before, after, we still have a darkened sky, and it's less affecting the buildings. It's less doing it. But you can make it even further. You can use a smoothness slider. If I move it a little bit to the left, and I lower the exposure a little bit, you can see that it's mostly affecting the sky. It's doing something a little bit weird here because the sky that's darkened is gonna reflect in the windows, which is fine. So you can move this back. But that's kind of the whole purpose, because there was a lot of people back in the day that used to post this photo where they darken the top of the photo, but everything else is darkened. Oh, by the way, guys, if you can take a minute and just smash the like button. Just destroy the like button. Tell me that you like this video. It really helps other people to see it. Also, leave me a comment. Tell me what you would like to learn. I try to do every week a video for you guys. Lightroom, Photoshop, photography. Just leave me a comment. I read every single one of your comments. And if by any chance you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, oh my gosh, click the subscribe button. Make sure you select all so you get a notification every time I come out with a video. As I told you, I'm doing about one a week, sometimes 2 weeks. I'm going crazy on YouTube, and voila. So let me show you another example, like on this black and white. I love to do that also on the black and white, make like a gradient. But again, this is Yosemite. Now El Capitan is dark, this is dark, Half Dome is dark. So same thing here, I can go to Range Mask, and I can move this to the right, and you see, and maybe move this a little bit maybe, and now check it out, before, after. See, El Capitan is darker, but slightly darker, but the sky is much darker. So usually what I do on a lens, by the way, a little trick, what I do on this kind of photos, I do two masks. I do one like this, and then I do another one for the very top of the photo, because I really like to close my black and white, like Ansel Adams style, where you really have the almost the top of the photo that's burned and the bottom that's kind of burned, to really focus the eyes of the person in the middle of the photo, maybe add a bit of contrast. Very, very important. So check it out, before, without the gradients, with the gradients. So that's what luminosity is. It's just gonna help you mask this. Let me show you again. I just wanna make sure you understand. So if I click here and select this gradient, you can see if I go here, now the sky, everything goes darker, and if I go to the right, only the sky. And I mean, it's not an exact science, meaning the sky is getting less darkened, but it's getting more darkened than the mountain, because look at the mask. The mask is pretty white on the sky and a little grayish on the mountain. And so that's what Luminosity Mask do. Now there's another feature of Luminosity Mask, which is called Color Mask. And let's say I want to change the color of that dress. So one way I could do it is I could go to circle, go to a circle here. Let me redo it. I'm going to make a circle around her. And I could go here in the U and just change it from blue to red. But we have two issues. You see, it changes skin there, which we don't want. And the red is only on a gradient. It's not everywhere. So if I unfeather this, the dress is red, no problem. But the skin is green and it's really weird. But check this out. If I go to Range Mask and I go to Colors this time, and I take this little target tool and I click just on the dress, boom, check it out. Only the dress has been changed. It's the mask created, isolated that dress because it's, you know, it was just blue in the middle of anything. And now I can change the dress with whatever color I want and it's working perfectly. And you can, you know, you can fine tune it with the amount here. So let me go back to red. I can fine tune it, you know, making really red or a bit less red. You know, and you're just fine-tuning the mask. You can see what the mask looks like by holding the Option key. But it's going to throw you off because it's really just isolating that color. That's why that color is so white. And it's pretty cool. Check it out. Before, after, I only change the color. And look, the skin doesn't change. Nothing else changed. It's really cool. Oh, guys, by the way, last week I did a video on my favorite Lightroom shortcuts, which you should know. This is 13 shortcuts. You can download them. The link is right under the video. You can print this and put it next to your computer. There's over 200 shortcuts in Lightroom. This is the 13 I've been using for 12 years. I think they are the most important ones. If you don't think they are the most important ones, you can let me know. You can leave me a comment. But all right, I'll see you in another video.